And the kind of the way that it came to me with my, I love watching sci-fi and all that kind of stuff. So I kind of see it this way, that God has a secretly encoded message that he is embedded within you. That while he was forming you and fashioning you, he also kind of threw in some messages and coding there about what he wants to do with you. As you know, last week I started talking about unlocking the dream that God has within us and how he's fashioned these days, the days fashioned for us, meaning what God has already encoded, literally encoded inside of me and you. And there are things that God has spoken to us. You may have caught glimpses of your future, may have caught glimpses of things that you're going to be doing and what you're going to be. And like Joseph, who when he got those, when God gave him those dreams when he was 17 years old, and it took 13 years for that stuff to come to pass, and it was the hardest, probably the most miserable 13 years of his life, of being betrayed by his brothers and sold into slavery and lied on by his slave master's wife and then put in prison. And when he had an opportunity to get out of prison early, the guy forgot about him, stayed in there even longer. And boy, and sometimes the dream that God has for your life, it can torment you. Anybody know what I mean? What I mean by torment you, and that is you look at where you could be or what the thing was spoken about you, and then you look at where you are. And all of us are living that in some way or another. There's what God said or what he showed me, and then I look at where I am, and this is nowhere near. In fact, it's just the opposite. You get to the point where you don't want to hear any more words. Don't give me no more prophecies. Don't encourage me no more. Because it seems like every time I get an encouraging word, then it gets worse. So rather than have anything get worse, just don't tell me nothing. Anybody know what I mean? Don't tell me nothing. Because if I ain't expecting nothing, then I don't have to have no warfare and no opposition. But that's really untrue. You need the expectation. You and I need the expectation. Sometimes all of us have felt that way. I don't want to get my hopes up, is what we say. I don't want to get my hopes up only to be disappointed. But we must get our hopes up, because if you don't have any hope, you'll just be stagnant. You won't do anything. And you keep feeling like, if I don't get my hopes up, then I won't be disappointed. But what's the thing that's worse than getting disappointment is to just be stagnant and don't do anything. And that stagnation has Harrisburg in a horrible grip. There are people who are now satisfied. There are thousands of people in Harrisburg who are satisfied with doing nothing. I don't want to get my hopes up because I don't want to be disappointed. But since you live your life with no hope, then there is no expectation. And if there is no expectation, then God can't move in your life, because faith is based upon us having a hope and an expectation upon a promise that God's given us. We must live by faith. The Bible says the just shall live by faith. So I can't live, you and I can't live our lives saying, don't give me no more good news. Don't give me no more dreams. Don't give me nothing that'll get my hopes up. No, that if you're still saying that, then I'm encouraging you, and I'm saying it to myself today, and I'm encouraging you to shut down that thought. That's a vain imagination. That's a thought that's lifting itself above the knowledge of God. What's the knowledge of God? The knowledge of God is, God, you keep your word. You wouldn't have told me if it wasn't true. You would have never said anything if it wasn't already done as far as you were concerned, because that's how God operates. God does stuff. He already does it, but we can't see it. God completes a thing, then he backs up and starts it. Oh, thank you, Lord. Then he'll tell us. But you have to understand, from God's standpoint, the only reason why he told us is because he's already finished it.